Hello, and welcome to FTCR's playthrough of Nights into Dreams. I'm MykonosFan, and I'm joined by the real FTA.
Hello, I am real.
And we're joined by the fake Photoshop addict, Tracker.
It's me, the dastardly Tracker.
Truly a despicable source of evil.
Obviously.
So, we're playing a non-Sonic Sonic Team game.
Hooray!
Isn't that amazing?
The best kind.
I will say, I'm gonna shoot my load a bit here. I'm not the biggest fan of this game, but you'd be a heartless sack of shit to not love this theme. This theme is just it's beautiful.
Nights has a soundtrack in general. It's just such a stellar soundtrack. I think that the folks behind Sonic CD soundtrack were involved, and you can kind of tell because it's amazing.
Well, it's weird. One of my favorite tracks from SA1 is the NiGHTS music when you play the NiGHTS board.
Well, yeah, exactly. They just reused that from this one, and
I was so bummed when that wasn't on the SA1 soundtrack. Like, why isn't that track on the soundtrack? It's the best track in the game.
it's just so damn good. It's just like, and it's like you can tell that it was done by the Sonic CD folks, because when they did Christmas Night in the Sonic level, the boss music is remixed from Sonic CD. So it's like they were just paying homage to it all.
I should get out in front and say it. We're saving Christmas Nights for when we have the actual Saturn disc, since the HD port we're playing doesn't have all of the extras.
Yeah.
So we're putting that behind.
Yeah, the HD port of Nights was based heavily on the PlayStation 2 port,
which
cut out all that content, and it really sucks, because even besides, obviously, the big one, which is, oh my god, you can play as Sonic, it had tons of cool stuff like Link Rush and stuff, which is all extra modes that really would have been good in the main game. Mm-hmm. In fact, I think that I might actually prefer Christmas Nights overall to regular Nights, because it just offers more to do. There's more, varied modes and stuff, and so I've seen lots of people say Christmas Nights is the better game, despite just being a demo. So, yeah.
It even gives you cool reasons to check in on holidays and stuff. Like, I turned on Nights today to play it, and I guess all during January it becomes Winter Nights and changes up some?
Yeah. They did that in the Christmas Nights, but then they incorporated all those seasonal changes into the HD port as part of the vanilla game. So, it's really cool. Of note is that the HD port, obviously, is all fancy, this is, again, based on PS2, but the widescreen isn't actually new. The original Sega Saturn version also runs in widescreen, which is...
Oh, really?
There's a widescreen mode. So I looked it up the other day, I was playing it, and I was like, oh, hang on, this has a widescreen mode. So running it through, running it through RGB in 16:9 is insane on Sega Saturn. it looks amazing. It's one of the few games you can do in 16:9 with an old game, and still looks amazing.
That's weird. If that was built into the original game, because obviously this version does include the Saturn version as well. I wonder why they didn't put the widescreen option on the Saturn graphics.
The thing with the Saturn mode in this is, it's technically not the Saturn version. It's basically just the PS2 version running with the Saturn models hacked in. Technically it's not the original. They just kind of texture hacked everything. The Saturn version, I think, has slightly different controls in terms of the analog stick and stuff, because the way the 3D pad on the Saturn worked was slightly different. So it's like, basically the controls on the Saturn version are the best version. And I'm here to champion the Saturn, because I love the Sega Saturn. So, yeah. But I do think the HD port's really good. It is it was well overdue, so it was really nice to see him do it.
I agree, and I hate how it pretty much did not perform well at all, sales-wise. I don't think it lit Sega's world up, considering... I forget the exact release order, but this was the last of the Heritage Collections, right? Back in 2012?
Yeah. And it's weird, because Blitz, who handled most of the stuff like Sonic CD and all that as well... they did actually run by tons of tests for Sega, because they did. They have working demos of Shenmue HD and all that.
Yeah,
they've
don't
confirmed
remind me.
That. So they can do more. And actually, right before we're recording this, Hideki Naganuma might be teasing something relating to Jet Set Radio Future. Now, that's a bit of a stretch, but I'm being hopeful.
It's been a wild few weeks for really cool Sega announcements. At the time of us recording this, we'll probably release this in 2028, but... here in early 2016, it's pretty good to be a Sega fan at the moment.
No, it wasn't, because that game Sega teased wasn't a new Sonic game. I don't give a shit. Don't want it.
I've been waiting so long for a good port of Power Drift, and we're finally getting one. It's beautiful.
I'm really excited to play that. I would just say,
probably of the three of us here, I am probably the one who likes this game the least. I don't hate it, but I mean, because, you know, Chris, you were saying how you were kind of bummed it didn't perform as well.
Yeah.
I'll be honest.
I can see why. Unless
you grew up with this game and you have nostalgia for it, which can be said true of a lot of games, I don't think this game holds up as well playing it fresh like I did in whenever this came out. Because the control isn't really great. I know the Saturn came, they had that kind of analog controller for this game. I pity the poor bastards having to play this game using only a D-pad on the Saturn.
Oh, yeah, I've actually tried that. That must have
been hell.
I have tried that and it was murder.
My disappointment was more with, Knights being a Sonic Team creation, and I think ever since Sonic Adventure, most Sonic games have had some weird reference to Knights. Yet I see a lot of Sonic fans who didn't really give the game a shake, even though it's easily available. And I think that's more my disappointment, because I still see so many posts that's like, I've never played it. It's like, it's right there. Just
and it's always on sale on Steam. I mean, in terms of Knights, I have the HD version on PS3, and I have two copies on the Saturn. So it's like, because apparently buying two copies of the same game on the same console makes sense. I mean, ask Sonic 1, I've got three Mega Drive copies of that. Four, actually. But,
fucking nerd!
It's like, yeah, but it's like, Knights is just, the first time I played it was the HD port. But I found it really fun, and then you go to the Saturn version, and I do think the controls are better.
I love this, Chris. Yeah. When you first explained to me how you can just break the game by doing tricks on a war is hilarious.
Yeah,
the trick system
was weird.
It's because we probably should explain the gameplay, since a lot of our audience probably has no idea what's going
on. That's the thing with Knights. At first, conveying the gameplay is a pain in the ass, because they never really explain it.
Which is my big thing, is as a lot of people have said, Sonic, games these days kind of have like maybe hold your hand a bit too much. But for this game, I was like, please, what the fuck am I supposed to do?
Yeah,
because they really throw you in the deep end with no help.
Yeah, my first few hours, I hated this game. I didn't get it. I'm like, oh, okay, everyone's just been overhyping this for years. I get it. And then I kept playing it, and then it clicked, I think.
Yeah, I'm watching this footage, and you're doing really well in terms of the bonus time and stuff, so yeah.
Yeah, because it's really an arcade-y score attack game.
Yeah,
and I
am amazed that they never bothered with an arcade port of this game. It would have been absolutely perfect for arcades.
Mm-hmm. So, it's definitely in the style of those Sega arcade classics that everyone loves that are a little obtuse and hard to break into.
Yeah.
And you kind of got to put some time in to understand what exactly is going on.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know. It's like, and they kind of also ramp up the difficulty later on, because you've got Stick Canyon, which is Elliot's level, and Jesus Christ.
Yeah, we'll get to that one with...
Yeah.
Oh, that one is tough the first time, but basically what's going on here is that every stage in Knights kind of has four... laps makes it sound like you've got to go through them four times, but there's four set routes throughout an area, and you're trying to get 20 of those blue chips to those weird things we've been breaking. That will give you something called an idiot orb, which is basically just things you collect that gets you onto the next course. And once you have all 20 blue chips, that's where you go for the higher score, and that's where you increase a letter rank at the end, much like Sonic Adventure 2 would later incorporate. And basically, Knights is just a weird on-rails aerial platforming score attack game?
Yeah, it's a score attack, basically, because it's like, once you've destroyed the prison thingy MacGuffins that you destroy with the blue chips, you don't have to go on to the next course immediately. You can go around for more laps and collect the blue chips, which become golden chips, and then you can get those for it. Now they do score multipliers and stuff. Oh, that's a good point as well. This game also introduced the A-Life.
Yeah,
which was developed in Sonic Adventure some more. I never really got with the A-Life in Knights, because the way you have to do it mid-level when you're on time limit is a pain in the ass.
Yeah, I don't like it at all, no.
But it's actually crazy in depth. They did it in the sequel, they did it more like the Child Garden, and you can get the Sega Saturn for them in that game and stuff. But,
I'm going to try and show off here, and I'm not going to do well at first. just to warn you why I'm just fucking around with his tail.
Yeah,
the bosses in this game, I think Gareth will be able to speak to more.
These bosses suck.
I have to agree, they really suck in this game.
The only one I actually like is Rihanna. I think the Rihanna fight is actually a lot of fun. Most of these bosses are just, they're badly... I would say they're not necessarily badly designed, but they don't explain what the fuck you're supposed to do.
It's not natural, no.
Yeah, and some of them, I think it's the next boss fight in the fish tank. Just half the time, I win by fuck knows how. I just win. It's fucking dumb.
Yeah, and with this boss, Gilwing, you're supposed to be able to paraloop his tail, and that can kill him instantly. But the thing is, trying to do it is
insane.
Torture. Yeah, I've literally never done it, and I've been playing this game for, like, years.
I've done it a few times, but it... trial and error, basically.
Admittedly, I don't play Knights enough to, whenever I do it, you can actually set the bosses to be random, so usually I just abuse the random feature so that I always have it so that I fight Rihanna. I can just get the best score.
Something we haven't talked about too much, but this boss track is so fucking sick.
It's one of my favorite Sonic Team music tracks in general. Like, to me, this entire soundtrack is probably in my top 10 at least. Sonic Team, which is saying considering it's Sonic Team music.
Again, Rihanna comes in to save there because the Rihanna battle theme is goddamn amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Theme of a tragic revenge, which is just, it's beautiful.
I love that big explosion, by the way.
I mean, it's weird because when you were on our Sonic Colors LP, plug, we were talking about how Sonic games have never really had good bosses. And I think this is something that me and Chris have talked about, just Sonic Team in general don't really know how to do good bosses. Because a lot of their early kind of 16-bit platformers, there you go, you show-off bastard, Chris. But a lot of their old 16-bit platformers never really have... good bosses. This is something that's, I guess, Sonic Team / Sega aren't really known for.
I'd say Generations bosses. Is probably the best bosses they've ever made.
You know, I was replaying it yesterday, and I was like, this is the only game where, obviously Time Eater aside, the bosses are a lot of fun in Generations.
Yeah.
Glad that carried over to Lost World alongside all the other great aspects of Generations.
Well, I mean, you know why? That's why, Chris, because they had the Knights DLC, they had to stick true to Knights, make sure the bosses were shit.
Yeah.
Sorry, Miles, you suck.
You know, I miss that. The Sonic Team used to always do that. Up until SA2, they would actually always credit Tails as Miles, but now they don't. It's like, it's Tails now.
Yeah.
Or if you play Sonic for Episode 2, you can fly Tails' tornado. Well, see, they put Tails and then they put apostrophe S, like, that's not how grammar works, you idiots. It's also not Tails' tornado, it's Sonic's plane. Fuck you, Scarlet, you ruined everything.
Hate that guy.
You don't spend too much time with him, but the control / animation of the kids is fucking horrendous.
It's just when you jump, they have no animation.
Look at how bad that jumping is!
Yeah, it's weird. They actually, it's weird because they put no animation into the main game's, kids. They put barely any attention into them. Yet when they came to putting Sonic in it, they put tons of attention into him in Christmas Nights because he does, the wheel of feet from the classic games. He does the spin jump and everything. He's super expressive on all that.
Having never seen Christmas Nights, is it just the Sonic Jam model, or is it a different model?
No, it's a completely different model. I think it was Sonic's first 3D appearance, or at least on a console. But, it's a completely different model.
Was Christmas Nights then before Sonic Jam?
Yes, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was. Where I'm not sure is if it came for Sonic the Fighters, and I can't be arsed looking it up. It's a completely different model, but it's a really great model. It looks like when you jump off the springs and stuff that Knights can fly off in this, he'll react by, his eyes just go tiny, he's surprised and stuff. It's really cute, but, yeah.
That's kind of cool. I would say, Tracker, you were speaking earlier about, your first time playing this. You may get this reference. My first time playing this was at Sega World in London. Did you ever visit Sega World, Tracker?
Sadly, by the time I was old enough to realise it existed, it had been closed.
Sega World was... There was a place in London, it used to be called the Trocadero, that, I guess, Sega World, and they turned it into an indoor theme park. I was lucky enough to go there. before when it first opened. So and all the arcade games were free. So I got to play Sonic the Fighter, Sega Sonic Arcade for free, and it was
I'm
great.
Jealous.
There was one room where they had a bunch of Saturns lined up, and they had like a bunch of them just had knights. I remember playing it, and as a kid, I was like, I don't know what the fuck's going on. Who the fuck I'm playing as? I'm not really enjoying it. I'm gonna go now and play some more Sonic the Fighters. Okay, bye.
I'm gonna go play a good game.
A good game. Sonic the Fighters.
Sonic Fighters. It's Gareth.
Sonic the Fighters. I mean, you know what? Sega World. Me and this kid were playing that game for so long. Somebody from the Sega World staff had to ask us to get off because there was this big line of people behind us who were trying to play it.
It's weird. Sonic the Fighters should be good, but because it's running off the Fighting Vipers engine, and Fighting Vipers is one of my favourite fighting games ever. But it's nowhere near as good.
I like it. It's simple as shit. I wouldn't call it a bad game. It's simple. But yeah. It's fun to waste 20 minutes on every now and again.
It's amusing.
I just wish Metal Sonic wasn't so cheap.
Me and Gareth knew all about that.
I'm glad they added Honey back into the HD version, though.
Yeah.
I need all
she's
my
so
fighting bikers
She's
reference.
So bad, though. She's like the worst fighter in the game. What's the point?
She can't be the worst fighter in the game because she's a giant fighting vipers reference, and that's just the best.
Have you played her to track her? She's
yeah, I have, but it's like... I don't care how bad she is because she's just a giant walking fighting vipers advert. I miss fighting vipers. Give me fighting vipers, pray.
No.
Good luck.
We got fighting vipers 2 in Europe. America didn't get that, but ever since it's just been dead. So dead.
Dead like the Knights franchise. That's right, I went there.
Hey, it's 20th anniversary this year. We might get a reference in the next Sonic game coming out.
I can see Sega maybe doing like a mobile game or something for it. I mean, Puyo Puyo's still very active and they've done weirder shit, so maybe we'll get a tiny like Knights mobile game.
You know, that doesn't sound like it would be awful, but it kind of does at the same time.
Yeah, because
so
they just do it like Sonic Runners.
Knights Runners, essentially.
Oh god, Knights
you're
Flyers.
To be fair, Knights and Riala are in that game, aren't they?
Yeah, exactly.
Aren't they assist characters?
Yeah, exactly. They shouldn't have made them playable. But, yeah.
There's a lot of things they should do, but we'll get off that track.
Yeah.
It can only lead to bad things.
Look, they should just port the Game Boy Advance version of Knights that came with Billy Hatcher. That's obviously the best idea. There was a Game Boy Advance version, and it was weird, and the music was surprisingly good.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
I've never even heard of that. Well, it was an actual night game?
Well, it was only the first level, but it was only Spring Valley, but it was proper nights on Game Boy Advance, and it looked really good. It was playable, I guess, even though I had to use D-pad.
Wait,
but,
and that came out before Sonic 1 Genesis, right?
Yeah.
So they got Knights to work on a Game Boy.
It was bundled with Billy Hatcher. It was like you could link, like I don't know, you did something in Billy Hatcher, and if you use a GameCube link cable, could unlock a Knights game. Because it was like, oh hey, look, Knights is in Billy Hatcher, now you can play Knights on your Game Boy. So, yeah.
So look at it this way, Knights fans. Sonic Team cares enough to get Knights working on Game Boy Advance, but not Sonic.
Yeah.
Exactly, because they know...
Only a tech demo, R.I.P.
Because they know Sonic will sell, Chris, even if it's shit.
Yes. Hence why we got Genesis and 06 in, like, the same year. I remember
and
begging
Riders.
For Sonic Genesis for Christmas, even though it didn't get released in the UK for some reason. And it's like, then I found out how bad it was, I was like, well, I dodged a bullet.
Christmas is saved. Thanks, Sonic Team.
So, I still got 06 on.
So, Tracker, you obviously are a big Saturn guy. Now, a lot of people would rank Knights as one of, if not one of, you know, the best game on the system. How does it rank for you?
It's definitely up there because it is one of the pinnacle titles. It shows, like, in terms of 3D gameplay, because a lot of the Saturn games hold to 2D because coding it in 3D was so hard on Saturn. But in terms of 3D experience, Knights is one of the best.
Well, you say that. I mean, it's still pretty much playing on a 2D plane. It's not really 3D if you think
about
it. Yeah,
but I mean,
like,
in terms of like what it does with the concepts and stuff, I think it works. Like, it's not sprites and stuff, so I think it works. I think it works well. But in terms of overall favourite Saturn game, I don't know what my favourite Saturn game is.
Duke Nukem 3D.
I'd probably be tempted to say I'd probably be tempted to say something like a fighting game because I play a lot of fighting games on Saturn. So I'd probably
Sonic
something R. like Fighters Mega Mix.
Sonic R.
Why is there a car? I've never noticed that. Why is there a broken car?
I'm trying to get it to the garage, but...
Yeah, you can guide it into a garage, and you get an achievement.
By the way, Gareth is sick while recording this, so don't worry, we're not killing him.
I have a cold, so.
I am sick, and watching that car break down is making me sick. That's hilarious. That's hilarious.
So, this little area in the stage, you'll probably time out here your first time, judging by watching me and Gareth play.
I did.
Yeah, I think, every time I play, I just forget where the hell to go. So, it's like, I'm always going to end up failing.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
The whole stage is a little confusing, but... because first you got to find that capsule, then you've only got... I've got 25 seconds now to try and get out of here. I think I time out in this recording? Nope, never mind.
So, do you think Naka views Knights as his crowning achievement over Sonic?
Well, it's like... Probably, yeah, because I think... I vaguely recall Shigeru Miyamoto mentioning this game. He said he wished... Yeah. I think he said he wished he created it.
Mm-hmm. I think there was an interview at some point where he was asked, "What one game do you could have wished you'd worked on?" And he said, "Knights," which coming from Miyamoto, that's good fucking praise.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This boss is one of the worst things in video game history.
It is. It is
fucking horrible.
I don't
there's
like
so
it.
Much, there's so much downtime between attacks, and it's just like, oh god, no.
And it uses no mechanics you use anywhere else in the game, and I think that's.
And it's also, like, the animation, and they don't... again, with the crappy animation, they don't ever really indicate the damage in it.
Yeah.
So it's just kind of crap.
That's the thing, though, because like, I think the first time I played this, like, I was just going back and forth. I swear I didn't even touch him, and he died. Like I visibly went under him, and he just dropped dead. I was like, okay.
Mm. Yeah, and I'm someone who's played this game a lot now, and you can see me, like, struggling through this.
Yeah.
In the actual levels, the camera is pretty good. In the bosses, whoever designed the camera for the boss section should have been fired.
Basically, whoever designed the bosses in general should be fired. That's what we're learning.
Which essentially means that Miyamoto don't know shit. If he worked on this game, that's why he wished he'd worked on this game. I could have fixed the bosses. Could have shown Naka how it's done.
Shiggy no diggy.
Oh well.
Basically, Naka, what we want to do, we want to fight Reala, but just spin him around 3 times and throw him into a bomb. That's the only boss we'll have in the game. Mario 64's got shit bosses.
Yeah. There's something in common.
Oh, Mario 64. Ooh, I should stop right now.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're at the end of the part.
Yeah.
Tracker, I'm glad we had you on. That was fun.
Yeah, it was great.
You hate Sonic Colors, you sack of shit.
I will never pass up an opportunity to talk about Sonic Team games that aren't Sonic or the Saturn. So yeah, thanks for having me on. It's been awesome.
You're welcome, even though I fell for your stupid Sonic Symphony Drive bullshit.
Yes, the best.
Get off
now
me.
What do I work on next? That's the question.
How about work on getting a life? Good night, everybody.
Get off my channel.